power so that we can really make the change that we need to have.
I appreciate the kind of breadth and depth of the issues that you all are working on, too, because racial justice is, you know, there needs to be justice in everything. And so many things are issues of racial justice, which maybe we don't always think of and consider that way. One of them that is like my favorite thing to talk about, because I'm a political nerd, is partisan gerrymandering. And the fate of partisan gerrymandering could also be up for debate in the Supreme Court this term, if the justices decide to weigh in on it. And so the fear, as Vox put it, is that since some justices already endorsed the view that state legislatures should have broad and potentially unchecked authority to determine how federal elections are conducted in their state, there is a tremendous risk that the court will now give Republican state legislatures expanded authority to draw gerrymandered congressional maps. This whole thing, we're going to actually do like a whole half a show on this soon, but your group is working to monitor the entire redistricting process. So please paint the picture for us of what that looks like and how this partisan gerrymandering is a bad, a nasty threat that is a racial justice issue.
Yeah, well, first of all, you know, gerrymandering, I like to break it down because gerrymandering basically means the manipulation of political lines for gain. It could be for political gain of one party, or it could be because of racism, right? And that's what we've seen over the history of this country is the manipulation of lines so that black folks and brown folks don't have power. And so where we are right now is that this is a power grab moment, right? And that is because the rising majority of black and brown people threaten the existing power structures that are still held by white folks. And so in many states, we still have Republican legislatures that are going to make sure that they keep their power. And so we're engaging with communities to make sure that we fight back. But also, you know, Aisha, that what is really important is the Freedom to Vote Act. Because the Freedom to Vote Act that has to be passed by Congress is in the Senate, and we're waiting for it to be introduced, and we're waiting for a vote on it, will get rid of partisan gerrymandering. Because we know that, you know, these Republicans, they're not playing around. And they are targeting black communities to take our power away. And so that's one thing I want to make sure folks understand is that we have got to push on the Senate to pass the Freedom to Vote Act, so that we can do away with gerrymandering, so that we can protect the vote to make sure we have national standards, so that we can make sure that we restore the voting rights of people with felony convictions. So all of that is in that bill, along with campaign finance. And so that's the way we're going to get a fix, but we have to get it passed. And if that requires modifying the filibuster, we have to make sure that happens too.
Mm-hmm. Judith Browne Dianis, thank you so much for the work that you are doing. All of these things are still moving, right? We got lawsuits, we waiting on legislation. So I would love to have you back with the status update on some of this stuff. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Doesn't matter whether you're sending a birthday card or a check to keep your lights on. Whatever you're putting in the mail is going to take longer to get there. And it's going to cost you more, too. I'll explain why next on Amplified.
Hey everyone, today's an exciting day. I'm joined by my old friend, Mr. Ellis Williams, aka Mr. Biggs.